we who plowed the prairies, built the cities where they trade, dug the mines and built the workshops and the towns where we played. Now we stand our cast of shining. It's the wonders we have made, but the union makes us strong.
These workers, 200 workers, are being thrown out on the street. 2 weeks before Christmas. What the hell is the matter with you people? Have you no heart?
We're here at Republic Windows and Doors. There's about 250. UE Local 1110 members who work here. They found out on Tuesday that their plant would be closing and that their last day of work would be Friday, yesterday.
En un fin de semana sacó una línea completa, estamos hablando aproximadamente como de 25 a 30 máquinas en una noche, en dos noches, en fin de semana.
Company told us that Bank of America cut off their financing. This is the same bank that got $25 billion in the federal bailout to extend credit to companies, keep the economy moving, and instead they cut off credit to this company, throwing 300 people out of work. In addition to that, they told us that the bank would not authorize them to pay people their vacation that they were owed or pay them money under the Warn Act.
Hay una acta que se llama Warn Act, acta de Warn Act, y que dice que tienen que notificar 60 días para el cierre de operaciones o nos tienen que pagar 60 días de pago.
The company told us they couldn't pay that money because Bank of America wouldn't authorize it. So we immediately called on Bank of America to come to the table and negotiate with us. It's just shameless that a bank that took all this taxpayer money is turning around, throwing people on the street with 3 days' notice, penniless, and then telling the company, no, we want all those windows inside. You can't pay your workers as you're required to do under federal and state laws. So we had a big demonstration outside of Bank of America on Wednesday. By Friday morning, they told us they'd be willing to come to the table. We did have a meeting. Congressman Luis Gutierrez helped make that happen. And Bank of America was there with the congressman, with the union, and the company had agreed to come but mysteriously didn't show up, which was very convenient for Bank of America because then they could not discuss anything with us because they needed the company to sign a waiver of confidentiality to be able to do that. So the workers were furious to learn that happened and unanimously voted after that to occupy the plant and not leave until Bank of America and Republic Windows and Doors pays them what they are owed, their vacations and their 60-day pay under the Warn Act.
When we have the meeting at 8 o'clock yesterday with the company, we come to give the message to our membership, and we have inside of the ARC meeting, we have some reporters from the radio stations and some of the newspapers with us, and when the company come to May Day meetings, they say, you know, they when the company is supposed to give us the notice to the our members, they ask to all reporters going out of the cafeteria, not to the company. So they being out of the cafeteria, and then they run their meeting. So after that, the Channel 2 appeared to run to cover the event. And the manager came and told him, you know what, you can report it from here. And he threw out from the lobby, tried to throw out to the lobby. And a couple of my coworkers and me, including me, we stopped, we put on the door and we say, we don't want to let him go out. She gotta cover her news. And I say, you know what, we are in a free country. We have freedom of speech. And they has to make the report. Let him, they reported. So when this happened, they made their report, but until they finished, they told him, you know what, you have to be out. It was real cold. She went out, and what I felt, she started calling the other media. You know what,
right.
This happened to me,
right.
And we have to cover the situation. They are in the plan, they planning to be in the plan the whole weekend, and it's when they start getting more power.
We've been here. It's our second day of a successful occupation. We're not going anywhere. Aquí estamos y no nos vamos.
Pensamos estar aquí hasta que nos den algo firmado o que nos den o que nos algo que nos garantice que se nos va a pagar lo que nos deben.
There's just like a list of workers on the side. They have to be able to know that that income will be there, and that when the job isn't there, that there'll be something that guarantees that they still have income, and they have assistance in getting into the next job. And that if the private sector isn't producing jobs, then the government needs to step in and produce jobs.
Yeah.
So this is a fight to make sure that these workers and their families have money, but this is a fight to make sure that all working people have the money that they need to support their families.
One possibility, and it's a, you know, it's big possibility, is to see to if we can reopen the factory, you know. And that's a long shot, but, you know, again, we'll have to wait and see. I mean, workers want jobs, you know, that's what they want. And if we can reopen this place, that would be great. And if not, to get what they are owed, the least that they deserve is, you know, what they are entitled to, what they have worked for, what they have earned.
This tactic was popular in the 1930s. and I think, you know, what was going on economically then.
Yeah.
So the fact that workers have decided they really have nothing to lose and they're willing to occupy a factory until they get what they're owed certainly says something about our economic times. It says something about the outrage about the bailout, because this is directly related to a company that got $25 billion in the bailout. And it says something about how you know, hopeless people feel about their future and how desperately they need this money to survive.
Nunca habían tomado una compañía adentro. Y ahora estamos adentro y no nos sacan hasta que no nos den lo que merecemos.
Take the company from the inside, and what we're doing. ¿Qué dijiste, Alfis?
Estamos aquí y no nos vamos.
We're here and we're not going anywhere.
All right.
Hasta que nos den lo que merecemos y lo que es justo.
What we get, what we are owed, what is fair.
Ellos creyeron que nos iban a sacar fácilmente.
They thought they would get rid of us easily.
Pero se equivocaron.
But they were wrong.
Aquí estamos en la lucha.
We're here fighting.
Y de aquí no nos vamos hasta que nos den lo que merecemos.
And we're not going anywhere until
lo
we
que
get
es justo y lo que es de nosotros.
What is fair and what is ours.
Hace dos semanas sacaron una maquinaria, dos líneas, y las para que iban para Ohio. Pero no alcanzaron a sacar lo demás porque nosotros nos pusimos en seguridad, cuidando.
En nuestra mente es lo que creemos, que están abriendo en algún otro lado. Hay rumores, pero no se ha confirmado nada.
My name is Clarence Bidak, and I'm Regional Director with FC Council 31, and we're here in support of the workers today. About the president of the Illinois Labor History Society and the steward, we are the steward of the Haymarket Monument, and so labor history is well represented here in Illinois and the rest of the world. And so those of AFSCME and those of the Labor History Society know all too well that the history of workers is built on issues like this today.
¿Cuántos años trabajó en la planta?
Trabajé por 19 años consecutivos.
¿Y en qué parte de la fábrica? ¿Qué hacía en la fábrica?
Casi todo el tiempo trabajé en el departamento donde se corta el vidrio para las ventanas.
¿Y en su familia cuánta gente hay y quién depende de su labor, de su cheques mensuales o semanales?
Ahorita somos cinco con mi esposo. Somos cinco de familia.
¿Y su esposo también trabajaba aquí o?
También trabajaba aquí, pero le dieron layoff en octubre.
Entonces a él le dieron layoff antes que a usted.
Sí, él salió en octubre y en noviembre dieron otro layoff y ahora fue cuando ya dijeron que iban a cerrar la compañía.
¿Y si pudo encontrar trabajo ahora después de que le dieron el layoff?
No, es muy difícil. Ahorita él anda trabajando por la oficina.
Y ¿temporal?
Sí, temporal. Y usted sabe que de la oficina días los mandan y días no. Es muy difícil la situación.
Pues sí, es difícil porque como tenemos niños en casa y es difícil dejarlos, que estamos todo el día aquí, pues casi no los vemos.
Más que nada, pues estamos todos aquí recibiendo el apoyo de la familia, de los esposos, porque como dice ella, no sabemos la hora en que nos vamos a poder ir, así que tenemos que estar buscando quién de la familia nos apoye para cuidar a los niños, porque podemos venir, pero no sabemos a qué hora nos vamos a ir, a qué horas va a haber noticia, y pues eso nos está descontrolando pues un poco.
If there's a need for the rest of the people, their coworkers, to come into the shop, you know, there's a phone tree and people start calling everybody and everybody comes on and does what they have to do.
Ustedes tienen un sistema de rotación en que se están cooperando, que unos de ustedes vienen en el día, otros vienen en la tarde y algunos en la noche. ¿Cómo están coordinando eso?
Eso hicieron tres turnos, como de 6 de la mañana a 2 de la tarde, el primer turno, de 2 de la tarde a 10 el segundo y de 10 a 5 de la mañana, a 6 de la mañana el tercer turno. Y pues en cada turno hay un grupo de trabajadores que se anotaron a los que mejor les acomodaba el turno.
Como mi esposo se va en la mañana a las oficinas a ver si lo mandan a trabajar, entonces yo por eso escogí el turno de la noche. Me vengo a las 9 de la noche y me voy a las 4 de la mañana para estar a la hora que él se va y quedarme yo con los niños. Llevar al otro a la escuela y ya me quedo en la casa con los dos más chiquitos. Por ejemplo, aquí hay familias que están trabajando los dos, la esposa y el esposo. Los niños se van a la escuela, entonces uno tiene que venir en la noche y otro en la mañana para quedarse uno con los niños a llevarlos a la escuela y todo eso.
¿Y como cuántas familias cree que haya que los dos padres estén trabajando en esta fábrica o estaban trabajando?
Han de ser como unos 20 matrimonios.
20 matrimonios.
The original plan was, and it still is in play, you know, for people to come 8-hour shifts. Some people here and there are coming at different hours. It's been a little hard too, being that we've had so many things happening, like press actions, you know, and at times we've wanted all the workers to come at a certain time, so it, you know, that takes away from the workers coming at, you know, certain hours that they were originally told to come. But for the most part, I mean, they're doing pretty good. We just had a small meeting with the workers here a while ago about what will possibly happen tomorrow at tomorrow's meeting and about the future, you know, in terms of staying here much longer, so on and so forth. But the workers are determined to stay here, you know, as long as they have to be. So, but they're good. They're really, really excited that they have gotten so much support. People coming by at all hours of the day, dropping food, money, and the attention that they have had from the media. I mean, they just are inspired more than ever.
¿Ustedes qué les podrían decir como ejemplo que están haciendo ustedes para que la gente se sienta protegida y que sientan que hay alguna cierta esperanza de que se puedan solucionar estos problemas?
Pues tratar de que no esté. Primero, ver nuestros derechos que tenemos y ya basarnos a lo de la ley que está, basarnos a eso y si ver si están haciendo una injusticia con nosotros, organizarnos y no dejar que los patrones nos quieran pisotear, porque nosotros simplemente estamos defendiendo lo que es justo para nosotros, nuestro trabajo.
Sí, más que nada es eso, educarnos sobre nuestros derechos.
Mira, nosotros al recibir esta noticia de que nos iban a cerrar la planta, no fue idea mía, no fue idea de mis organizadores, esto fue idea espontánea de todos y cada uno de mis compañeros de trabajo que decidimos, ¿sabes qué? Esto no nos lo pueden hacer.
Well, first of all, the union called me as a member of the Financial Services Committee to come and assist them in this process. And we started collaborating last Wednesday. We put together a meeting Friday, but the company didn't show up. We need them to open up the books so that we can see the economic condition of the company. We can see what their receivables are, how much money they have, and try to figure out why they're not paying the workers what they're owed according to federal law under the WARN Act. They're owed 60 days when you terminate abruptly operations and productions. That's federal law. So we're going to, so we had the meeting. We're going to have another one tomorrow at 4 o'clock. And our goal is, obviously, some wish to see if we can keep the plant operating. Maybe that is something we're going to be able to obtain. But first and foremost, I think that we should make sure that these workers are either working and put back to work. This is an energy star operation, right? The President-elect Obama says we should invest in companies that conserve energy. Well, this is a production plant that has windows that conserve energy. So that's an energy-producing product. We shouldn't close the plant down. That's first and foremost. But very important, look, if you're going to close down operations, then pay the workers the 60 days. Some workers have been here for 34 years. And we want to make sure that the owners of this plant just don't pick up, take the machines with them, not pay the workers, and open up operations somewhere else, leaving the workers without their just pay and compensation for their work.
So are you sure that the company is going to show up for the meeting tomorrow?
Well, I'm hopeful. I'm very, very hopeful that they will show up tomorrow. That's obviously our goal, so that they can sign a release of confidentiality so that we can learn more about the economic situation and find out just what the responsibilities of the parties are. Look, I'm here to protect the wages and the benefits that these workers have rightfully earned. It's not a gift. They've earned them. And the federal law is pretty clear on this matter. So let's make sure that government, while it's bailing out Wall Street and bankers, also is saying, I'm going to raise my voice, and I'm going to make sure that government can work for people on Main Street.
So this factory is setting an example, right?
Well, I think they're setting an example. Many people wonder why they're here. Well, they're here protecting their labor. They worked. Yeah, there are hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of windows out there that are going to be delivered to somebody. But shouldn't we pay the workers for their labor before we hand over the product to somebody?
People over profits.
Yeah, I think that's the way it should work.
¿Qué queremos? Justicia.
¿Cuándo?
¿Qué se puede hacer la gente de afuera para apoyar?
La energía.
We need
la
energy.
Energía
a,
que transmiten al
they,
estar aquí
they,
con nosotros.
Show us their support, that they come
en este frío,
in this cold, la,
el calor que nos dan.
It gives us warmth.
El día 10 de noviembre en las calles de Chicago salieron los filipinos.
¡Viva los filipinos!
¡Viva los filipinos!
Y después de una semana para unirse en la batalla salieron los mexicanos. ¡Viva los mexicanos! Vamos juntos, compañeros. Como decía Armando Robles, esta huelga ganaremos, sí señor. Viva la revolución, viva nuestra asociación, viva nuestra unión. Viva la huelga en el fin.
Viva
tuya. Viva la causa en la historia. La raza llena de gloria, la victoria.
The community getting together to do many things at once. One of them is obviously, and first and foremost, in solidarity with Republic Windows and Doors workers, because they are Latino workers, they are immigrant workers, and these people here feel very tied in with that struggle. Some of the workers from Republic live in this area. The second one is that this is the strip, the most commercial, most important commercial strip in the Latino community, and we have been suffering the closure of so many small shops. But if you put them together, that's another 300 workers who are losing their jobs. So what we are doing is, you know, focusing in this particular branch of Bank of America to request the credit for Republic, but also the credit for 26th Street, because we need the credits here also so no more workers lose their jobs. And last, but not least, we are spreading the word. What we want is everybody to know that there's a struggle going on that consists in sitting in your factory when you are told that you are laid off or the factory is closed. I think that's the attitude every worker in the United States should take. And immigrant workers know very good about that because they have done it in their countries of origin. They know what a sitting is, they know what a strike is, they know how to close down a factory or a shop.
We are going inside the bank to try to speak to the managers.
We'll ask the manager to come outside, Jorge, so we can speak to him on the sidewalk.
We don't want your sidewalk, we want your money. You got bailed out.
We got sold out.
About opening the savings account here. But when I walked up here and I heard what was going on, I have to say, first of all, after the Feds passed that $700 billion bailout, and banks all over the country, including Bank of America, are providing for their customers, there's no way, no how, I'm going to open a savings account.
Excellent.
They gave me 30 seconds to say what we had to say, and I used 25. And they said they already know, they are up to here, we are interrupting their business, they are aware of the situation, downtown is aware of the situation, and they will take care of it. What that means, we don't know, but that's exactly what we intended to do here today, you know, put pressure and send a message that this is not only one factory and one location in the north side, this is all over, and it's going to spread nationwide. Okay,
why do you think an action like this, I mean an occupation of a factory, which doesn't seem like a very common thing to do, is happening in Chicago and not anywhere else?
Chicago could become an example like Haymarket, where people can peaceably organize. I believe that we could be more actions like this, like the next time anyone tries any funny business like this, you know, we'll all be here and we'll play footage of all the politicians and we'll say, where are you in this action? Because if they're all here as a token event, we'll have as a matter of record.
Why do you think that Chicago politicians had such a supporting reaction towards this, somewhat illegal occupation of a factory? This is not something that's very common.
True. I think the reason they're doing it is because of the R word that our president, who was not elected, issued the other day. He said recession and 10% unemployment. So I believe that's why they're here. Because they really don't want to see another recession happen at the micro level when they might have been able to stop it.
So you don't expect that this will be an isolated situation during this recession when frustrated workers occupy a plant. I mean, it happens in other countries, but the United States has not seen anything like this. This is a historical event.
Since 1930s, right. That's true. I think if they see it, they'll do it. Now, maybe they'll again be mostly Hispanic. Maybe no one else has the cojones to do this, but you would think any wronged worker of any stripe would do it.
Vámonos a chambear en el norte. Vámonos a chambear. Ya no llores corazón, no nos van a desraizar.
just set up a food committee inside because we're getting so much food, which is great, and I'm not telling people to stop just because we're getting so much. But, you know, that's what they did. They voted on having a food committee to monitor, basically, the area where all the food is, keep it clean, so on and so forth.
Estamos los trabajadores dentro de la compañía y estamos en una vigilia, estamos en una acción pacífica y estamos haciendo valer nuestros derechos. Estamos haciendo que nos respeten, que no nos pisotee el patrón, como siempre lo ha hecho.
It's history, you know, I never imagined something small right now is so bigger, you know, but this is thanks for everybody, you know, this is for support the people is making the difference right now for us, not only for us, you know, who complain for the one company is not respect the rights for the worker, you know, it's disappear right now, it's changing, the time is changing right now, isn't that, you see the president changing the history of this country, now this company is changing the history too. Us right now is on a small tree, planting a small tree. This tree, for so bigger, is making fruit. Now, the tree is planting, the fruit is every United States, you know, follow this sample.
Todos tenemos derechos y no deben de tener temor a represalias. Si no hacemos valer nuestros derechos, si no ponemos el mayor esfuerzo de nuestra unión, porque debemos de estar unidos cuando el patrón trata de pisotearnos, entonces todo se va abajo, pero si nos mantenemos unidos, todo se puede, todo se logra. Es nomás cuestión de tener el valor de hacerlo. Tenemos derechos y la ley nos protege.
Certainly we're hopeful that maybe tomorrow will bring resolution. I think this is definitely good news that there is progress being made, that all parties want to talk, so we're happy about that. But of course, no one's leaving the plant yet, so the occupation will continue and will continue until there's a resolution.
Hay que empezar nuestra lucha desde nuestras fuentes de trabajo, que el país este prospere como lo que es, la superpotencia. No vamos a permitir que vayamos a caer a un tercer mundo nomás por opresión.
Yo creo que el tono que asumió el Banco de América fue una de reconciliación. Articularon unas posiciones en las cuales nos indicaron que ellos quieren resolver esto de una manera en la cual los trabajadores se les tiene justicia.
Yeah, I'm waiting, everybody excited, you know. And that one more day, that's good, I'm happy. One more day here.
Trabajadores de mi raza, yo les vengo aquí a cantar. Y en este radio chamba, vamos todos a luchar. En el 887 todos escuchar, estamos todos en radio chamba y vamos a luchar, hermanitos de mi raza, y yo me vengo a cantar.
Trying to figure out why they said they shut down the company, but then you have workers. Which is three ladies working in the office. We're wondering where are they getting paid from if the company is supposed to be closed.
Mm-hmm. IWW in New York, Rhode Island, and Detroit have been confirmed so far, are doing solidarity actions, and then Rhode Island's also doing an action on Friday. And so we're still putting the word out. We'll see what other groups in the IWW sign on and do actions. Real short notice, but we're getting the word out, and then we're going to be coordinating within our union that way.
Nada más queremos dejar saber que los trabajadores han recibido un arreglo floral de hermanos y hermanas de el sindicato de los Carpenters, el local 1281, desde Anchorage, Alaska. Es Ace y Dube. Okay.
Okay, doing well, thank you. Whoa! No press. Sorry, the press does not go in. Thank you.
I was quite amazed that there could be a sit-in in America, and that's one thing, and that they weren't thrown out by the police, because it's very interesting, so we had to go here and cover it for the magazine.
So did you fly in today?
No, actually I flew in on Saturday to cover a lockout in Ohio in a Norwegian-owned company there. It's an auto part company. They have been locked out since April, so it's actually that case has been given priority by the steel workers in Norway. And when we got there, we also heard on television about this issue, so we drove in today.
We had a productive day of negotiations today. Parties were working in good faith. A lot of hard issues to deal with. We're very close to settlement, but we couldn't quite get it done today. We're meeting again at 1 o'clock tomorrow. We're quite hopeful that we can get it done at that point. But, you know, until you have an agreement final, you don't have an agreement. So, you know, we're getting there, but we're not quite there yet.
Yeah, I think that accurately describes if yesterday we were halfway there, today we're a lot further. I mean, so between the 2 days, each day of negotiation has occurred to the benefit of the workers. So those are good days. Nothing's been taken away. We just keep adding and adding. You know, the union and I, we're dealing with so many issues of pensions and health care benefits and how much everything costs, how much everybody's owed in vacation time, and what 60 days means at $10 an hour or $14 an hour or whatever the wage is. So there's a lot of issues. And how is it we guarantee, given the complicated legal structure of our system, it's not like you can just say, write me a check. Things got to go through this process. And as it goes through that process, we don't make sure there's not deductions, right, made against the union. So I'll see my brothers tomorrow.
Yeah, take care.
All right.
We want to still keep the plan open until we got something in writing, and we be sure we secure our members. Until we have secure everything, we're going to stay. After that, we leave.
It is against federal law. We're seeing a lot of families and husbands.
There were two sticky points in the conversations today. One of them was
a press release sent out by Bank of America saying that the thing had been solved. It incites the idea that the workers should leave the plant because everything is arranged. And that wasn't real. A lot of time was spent on discussing that point, that misinformation on part of the Bank of America. And the other sticky point was that a part of the economic package to rescue Republic Windows and Doors was the owner's demand, or the president's demand, that the package should include his car payment for over a year. But not only his car payments, but other three cars from executives of the company for a total of $11,000 a month. The workers completely refused. The workers stated that only people who had been carrying signs and picketing and occupying the company should benefit from the economic rescue of the company.
Just in general, what are your feelings about what's happening with the economy, the bailout of the banks, and the fact that a lot of people are losing jobs?
Like I say, I think it's messed up. I mean, the government or somebody ought to do something for the people. Like the big shots still getting their money. What about the little people, right?
Strong. Is it
built the cities where they trade, dug the mines and built the workshops, endless miles of railroad laid. Now we stand our cast and starving amidst the wonders we have made, but the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever, solidarity forever, solidarity forever, for the union makes us strong.
En la noche, por ahí como a las 8:30, que nos dijo que ya terminamos de firmar los documentos en el banco junto con la unión y la compañía. Entonces venimos y dimos la noticia a nuestros compañeros acá en Republic Windows and Doors, en la cafetería, y hicimos una votación a ver si aceptábamos lo que nos habían ofrecido, y pues fue decisión unánime, decidimos que aceptábamos lo que nos habían dado, y pues ahí fue donde salimos afuera, terminó la ocupación de la planta.
Viva la huelga en el fin, viva la causa en la historia, la raza llena de gloria, la victoria va a cumplir. Vamos juntos, compañeros, como dice Armando Robles, esta huelga ganaremos. ¡Viva la revolución! ¡Viva la revolución!
¡Viva, viva!
Nuestra asociación, viva huelga en general. ¡Sí, señor! Vamos a chambear, muchachos.
Vamos a chambear, maestro.
Vámonos a chambear en el norte. Vámonos a chambear en el sur. Vámonos hasta New York. Vámonos a chambear, me and you. Ya no llores, corazón. No nos van a desraizar, la semilla está bien sembrada. No nos van a desraizar. Vámonos a chambear en el norte. Vámonos a chambear en el sur. Vámonos a chambear aquí en Chicago. Hacemos radio chamba for me and you.
La unión hace la fuerza, y que a veces hay que meter presión y estar unidos para que se hagan cumplir las leyes, que a veces pues estos gente, sobre todo banqueros en este caso y empresarios, se hacen de la vista gorda y creen que nosotros nos vamos a quedar callados y dejar que las cosas pasen. Pero bueno, se demuestra una vez más que, pues bueno, como lo comentó el compañero, todas estas organizaciones y gentes, personas que apoyaron este movimiento, pues aquí están los resultados, ¿no?